Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Here we are, my friends, one of the last live shows of the first month of 2011. We've got a jam-packed transmission lined up for you. Obviously, the protest exploding all over the Middle East and North Africa are intensifying all over Egypt. The New York Times is now reporting that in Alexandria and also in Cairo, the police are stopping their clashes with the citizens and shaking hands with them and sharing bottled water. That's what happened in 89 with Ceausescu in Romania. And so more and more it looks like Egypt is going to fall to the population. The Egyptian government is arresting basically the entire leadership of the Muslim Brotherhood. Hosni Mubarak is a dictator. Joe Biden is running around, sticking his finger in everybody's face, saying, don't call him a dictator. Just like we heard last week, don't call Hu Jintao a dictator. They are dictators. And even the Sydney Morning Herald gets it right when they says the U.S. sticks to its old playbook of trying to prop up dictators. Now, I've seen some people saying that the West, and last week, you know, we looked at that with some guests on air, that the West is somehow financing that. There is no evidence of this. Tunisia, Yemen, and Egypt are all Western puppet states with dictatorships basically over them. And the population, you know, in a way, the globalists are causing this because in the last year, as the dollar's been devalued, causing world commodity prices in fuel and mainly food to go up, you've got 50-plus percent of the Egyptian population making $2 a day or less. About half the population is on some form of food stamps, just like 43 million Americans are on food stamps. They're on the equivalent of food stamps. They go to these government facilities and are given food, and they're starving. I mean, you look at these rioters, they are very skinny. I mean, they look malnourished. They're, you know, their cheeks are sucked in. And, boy, a hungry stomach makes an angry person. People are so depressed over not being able to feed their children, they're setting themselves on fire, as you know, in the last 3 days. That's desperation right there. Just like we had the Romanian parliament, one of the TV producers there for government TV, throwing himself off the balcony and almost killing himself, saying, you've sold our country out, you've sold our children out, and he jumped off a three-story balcony head first, trying to kill himself. This isn't just something that Muslims do or Buddhists do. Humans do this when they get desperate. And it's the IMF and the World Bank are saying, cut all of your budgets. Everything must go to us on interest on your debt. And these countries, some of them are paying over 20% interest on made-up fiat currency owed to the bankers because the bankers sold them on investing in derivatives. This all started 12 years ago in 1999. And it's going to suck down Greece. It's going to suck down Ireland. It's going to suck down Spain and Portugal and England and the United States. In fact, The Economist magazine is out today saying that, yes, the United States is actually in worse shape than Greece is with its finances. And that's true. And the issue here is I'm all for cutting government spending because that's what gets us dependent so the bankers can hold us hostage and say, pay higher taxes, do what we say, or we'll cut off the basic food stamps and things that people are now dependent on. But once you're already in the situation and once you're dealing with $1,500 trillion and Davos, the banker's demanding another $100 trillion they can leverage out to a quadrillion, $1,000 trillion, you could cut everything. You could pay 100% taxes. You could never pay all this back. It's not owed. It's made up. And that's the big secret. I hear all these conservatives on radio saying, we got to cut this, we got to cut that. That'll do nothing. Let me explain that again. Zero. Zero. You've got to default on all this debt. We'll be right back. Hi, folks. This is Alex Jones asking you for a minute of your time to tell you about soap. Not detergents, but good old-fashioned pure soap made by the Calbin Soap Company, a family-owned and operated American company. My family, staff, friends, and radio listeners are constantly telling me how much they love these products for bath, hair, laundry, and dishes. There is nothing like these factory-direct, big-money-saving, triple-concentrated soaps anywhere. Get a free detailed catalog by calling 800-340-7091 or see them online at 5starsoap.com or infowars.com. Let's talk to the owner of 5 Star Soap, Marty Schachter, and see what he has to say.
As founder and owner for over 63 years, people keep asking me, how's business? I'm happy to say our business is going down the drain. Call us at 1-800-340-7091. Visit our website, 5starsoap.com, for buying our 1 to 2 month soap sampler. Thank you.
A very wealthy U.S. citizen is predicting that in 2011, we will witness the most important day in America in more than 50 years. He says it will change everything about our lives. The way you shop, travel, invest, educate your children, and even how you take care of your health and your own family. Now, this man has made some outrageous predictions over the years. The crazy part is, he's usually right. You see, he predicted the collapse of GM, Fannie Mae, Freddie Mac, and America's biggest mall owner, General Growth Properties. In fact, Barron's called his work a dire prophecy. Recently, he created a video, which you can watch online for free, detailing his biggest and most important prediction yet, and it's a real eye-opener. I can't stress this enough. You should at least watch this free video online today. He explains everything you need to know, including simple steps you can take to protect yourself. You can find the video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com. Watch the free video at www.endofamerica3.com. That's endofamerica3.com.
Alex told you the government announced recently that the recession is over. It ended on June of 2009. The millions of Americans unable to find work might not agree. Perhaps the recession ended for the bankers and government employees, but for the rest of us, things seem to be getting worse. Gold and silver haven't heard the news either. They've begun their long-expected journey to the moon. In addition to converting your shrinking dollars into gold and silver, you should consider a food savings account from eFoods Direct. They both make fabulous investments. Food is our greatest dependency, and we know it will be more precious than any financial resource. You and your family need food to survive a crisis, and you can't eat paper, stocks, or metals. Alex has been urging you to invest in delicious, easy-fix meals to enjoy now or save for long-term. This will freeze the cost of your food while you can still afford it. Visit eFoodsDirect.com on the internet or call 800-409-5633. That's eFoodsDirect.com or 800-409-5633.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Okay, my friends, very important transmission today, obviously, with what's happening all over the world. I'm going to attempt to cover all of this news that's in front of me. It, of course, is the 28th day of January 2011. I want to talk about the V for Victory operation we launched 7 days ago last Friday. It has been the most wildly successful grassroots program we've ever launched. It is just off the charts, the huge response we're seeing. I want to spend some time on that today, and we've been sent scores of new videos and flyers and activist material we're going to be posting up on Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com today. Obviously, a few days ago, I had Brad Meltzer of Decoded, the best-selling author, on. And Mark Dyce did not like what they did with the episode that he was in. And I do see a lot of big globalist connections. Meltzer said that I would be pleased with the show and that he actually agreed with me at the end of the show. I have to say it was a whitewash overall and that it was a mixed bag of where they would show both sides. They would show what I had to say. And all the activists in it said that, you know, they're setting up global government corruption, that it's dangerous what's happening. But then they made fun of me and said that I was basically wrong about a skull and bones connection with no proof. And then the host of the show at the end say, oh, we don't think it's a bad thing. Gee, we wish we could be members, and basically act like they want to be groupies, especially the woman host. Then they cut to Meltzer at the end, and he says, well, I disagree with my host. I think overall it's probably bad, but it's still a good club. But I'm surprised this made it on national TV. But it shows how the internet and alternative media has pushed these issues out there where the establishment, 11 years after I snuck in, can't cover it up anymore. But I'm going to get Meltzer back on next week. He said he'd come on, and we'll really go over this, and I'll have time to get some clips from the show. We forgot to record it up here last night. I did record it at home, but we've got to get that transferred over. I'm going to play a few of these clips coming up next week. Separately, obviously, we're going to be getting into the economy. Egypt on the verge of the government being overthrown. We've got Wayne Madsen joining us in 22 minutes from now to give us his take. Larry Pratt joins us in the middle of the next hour, the head of Gun Owners of America, to talk about Obama throwing down the gauntlet yesterday and saying, yes, within 2 weeks, he's going to call for and try to get introduced a raft of draconian victim disarmament. And we've got our Friday visit. He wasn't with us last Friday, but we've got our Friday visit coming up with Bob Chapman. In the last 30 minutes, we're going to get Lindsey Williams to pop in with some new developments on that front. So a jam-packed broadcast, obviously, today. One other little issue that I'm going to be playing next week. I got contacted a few weeks ago by the management company for Aerosmith, and I was told that the legendary guitarist Joe Perry had dedicated his new solo album to yours truly. Have Guitar Will Travel is the name of the album. Downloaded it yesterday. They're mailing me a copy. Excellent music, obviously. But talked to Joe for about an hour yesterday. And he wants us to, and I'm honored to play some of it on the show. And it deals with the New World Order and obviously what's in the water. And the whole globalist program, Police State, especially two tracks on the new album. So very exciting to have folks reach out from Aerosmith. Almost on a weekly basis, I get contacted by big Hollywood stars, huge musicians, and 99% of the time, or I'd say 98% of the time, they don't want to come on air. They just privately want to say, we appreciate what you're doing. And the reason that's important is it shows the reach of this broadcast and that celebrities across the board are getting out of the left-right paradigm and really waking up to the real nature of the world. That shows where popular culture is going and is another big win for liberty. But who knows, in the future, you may hear Joe Perry and others here on the broadcast. I don't really push for folks to come on the show, but certainly very well-spoken guy. I talked to him for more than an hour yesterday, and his wife is also great and very informed, extremely informed about what's going on in the world today. In fact, he said to me, he said, you know, living in the world today, we're living on the edge. We need to get that for bumper music. Because in fact, years ago, I heard that song. We've all heard it many times and thought, I ought to use that as bumper music and never got around to it. So let's get Living on the Edge and maybe play a bit of that from Aerosmith today. Here on the broadcast. But next week, we're going to be playing some of Joe Perry's solo music. And right there in the insert, I was on iTunes looking at it. It's dedicated to Alex Jones and the Sea Shepherds, who certainly do a good job trying to expose the killing of whales. That's a big area. I don't like killing elephants and whales and things like that. They almost extincted whales in the last century. But very, very honored that that is going on. Okay, let me just... Obviously, I'm going to get into what's happening in the Middle East and North Africa first here. But then I want to get into this report, In Your Face, dealing with Atlanta Police Department.